What's up, YouTube? We're back at it again with another episode of The Young and Thoughtful. And today, we are going to be talking about how the dating scene in college ripped my confidence apart. So anyways, I know what a lot of people are going to say, like, oh, bam, you had a girlfriend? Don't ask silly questions, bro. But anyways, kind of starting off, because I'm more considered like the dating scene. It's like more talking, more getting to know people, like that more talking stages type of thing, right? And like I said before in previous videos, you know, throughout my college experience, I felt like I've done well for myself. So like freshman year, dang, I'm really about to go into it, but not too much into it. But I'm really about to go into that. But anyways, freshman year, I was hooping a little bit. Sophomore year, we started to hoop a little bit more. And now this junior year, now we hoop a bit. So, but anyways, to kind of go into it, right? So throughout all of those type of years, throughout all of my years in college, you know, there's definitely been, you know, some girl or, you know, girls I've like seen and talked to and stuff like that, right? And I've really liked these girls that I've talked to. And you know, one of the things that I noticed is like, with a lot of them, I noticed that, you know, as I talk to these girls and stuff like that, and I get to know them and stuff like that. But once, you know, I kind of showed my personality to, you know, because a lot of times, like, once you're getting to know people, you don't really know them. You have an idea about them in your head and stuff like that. But, you know, when it came to me, when I was, like, talking to these girls and stuff like that, like, I noticed, like, when I started to, like, show my personality, you know, when I started to, like, actually, like, show them the inner works and, like, show them my personality and how I was, like, and stuff like that, right? It was almost like they, like, kind of, like, as soon as I wanted to like really show myself, my real self, they kind of like pulled back. And, you know, even to the point where it was like, okay, like, wow, like why do they want to pull back and stuff like that? Because, you know, now I'm like even thinking in my head, like, oh, I want to take you like more serious and stuff like that. But at the end of it, they're just like, you know, once I show that personality, my personality side, they're like, nah, I don't think it's going to work out or this or that, stuff like that, right? And that would just leave me crushed because, you know, it happened several times throughout my whole college, you know, season. And, well, yeah, more than several times. But who's keeping count? But anyways, and from that like really ripped my confidence. I'll be honest, that really ripped my confidence because at the end of the day, I'm asking myself questions like, bro, like, what is it about me that, you know, I feel like, you know, I have a great personality. I feel like I look good. I have a great personality. I have good, great values, great morals, come from a good background, all that type of stuff, right? And yet you are not willing, you know, you don't see me as somebody who's willing to like to commit to or willing to take serious. Well, commit is a bit of a stretch, but willing to take serious. And then, like, you know, come to find out, like, you know, and then, you know, after things end and then you see, like, the person that they're with, you know, they see the person that, you know, they decide to take serious or do stuff like that with. And then it's like, oh, that's the person you're choosing over me? Like, that's the person? And then I'm over here thinking, okay, what's wrong with me? All right, what's wrong with me? Like I said, I feel like I have great, you know, attributes and stuff like that. You know, where am I lacking? Like, what's wrong with me that somebody isn't willing to see me in that light? What is wrong with me that somebody isn't seeing me worthy enough to see me like that? So, yeah, that one, it definitely did a toll with me, and it ripped my confidence when it came to that dating scene or when it came to the talking scene in college. So, kind of transitioning in, you know, even to more of the solution side and to all of my, you know, to all of my viewers that are possibly going through the same things and stuff like that, man. And this is something that I had to tap into, you know, over the summer and throughout this year that I feel like God's been teaching me too. It's like, man, like not everybody, here's the thing. What's the best way to put this, right? The greatest basketball player of all time. Well, I think he's second. I think LeBron is number one, but arguably one of the greatest basketball players of all time, literally of all time, Michael Jordan, was cut from his basketball team in high school. Think about that. He was cut, literally the greatest player of all time in basketball was cut from his high school team. Or excuse me, was his middle school team? One of the teams when he was younger. Yet he still became the greatest player of all time. And that goes into showing, and I kind of translate into more like confidence-wise is this, where it's like, at the end of the day, if you are really confident within yourself and you know yourself really, really well to know that, hey, I am confident in who I am. I know who I am and I know what to bring to the table is. And even if I don't even bring it to the table, I'm still confident in who I am because my personality is great enough. Me being who I am and just who I am is great enough. Brother, you're good. Bro, you're already the greatest player of all time. In that case, in that standard, it's like, what's the best? What is the best way I can really put it? At the end of the day, if you're really confident within yourself and you know who you are, guess what? It doesn't even matter because some people won't be able to really see you in your form. A lot of people step on gemstones, man. I made a TikTok video about this in the past. A lot of people step on gemstones, valuable gemstones, and they feel like they're rocks. A lot of people step over them. They're overlooked. And that's what happens. They're overlooked. But trust me, the right person or the right people will notice you. The right people will notice that gemstone. The right people will notice that player. And that just goes to show that at the end of the day, man, if somebody doesn't, if somebody's not willing to take you serious, or somebody doesn't like you, or somebody, or this even translate into other aspects of life. If you didn't get that internship, if you didn't get that job, if this person isn't talking to you, if that friend isn't doing this and that, at the end of the day, guess what? It's their loss. Because at the end of the day, if you're really confident who you say you are and you are the person that you say you are, somebody's gonna find you valuable. Somebody's gonna appreciate you so much. And guess what? Don't lose confidence in that. Don't lose confidence in that. Because, and it will happen. Somebody is going to peep into it to be like, oh, yeah, I know who you are. Oh, yeah, you? Oh, yeah. Let me snag her. Let me snag him. Oh, yeah. Come join the team. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They're gonna love you. Trust me. And they're going to appreciate you for just who you are. You don't have to act like nobody. You don't have to imitate nobody, just to get somebody to like you. No. Because now you're losing confidence in yourself. Trust me, just the way you are, just the best version of yourself, just the way you are, somebody's gonna appreciate you so much. And you gotta have confidence in that. So yeah, man, that's really what is it's been about. One of the things that I've tapped into when it came to the dating scene in college or the talking scene in college, man, because I'll be honest, before I knew that, it really ripped my confidence. I wouldn't say I was, I wouldn't say I was heartbroken. I feel like that's a bit of a stretch, but it was more, it hurt my heart a little bit. It hurt my heart a little bit. It hurt my heart a little bit. But, at the end of the day, man, dog, if you really see who you say you are, bro, somebody is gonna come along the line and really appreciate you, and it will shock you that they're gonna be like, man, like you're gold, you're a diamond. I can't believe I found you. Trust me, that person is there, and trust me, there will be multiple people like that. They'll be like, wow, I have you, I have you. So, yeah, man, I feel like a lot of people need to hear that. I feel like a lot of people need to hear that because a lot of people are acting like people that they're not just to get somebody to like them or just to get somebody to like them. Yeah. So you don't need to act like that because at the end of the day, man, somebody's going to love you for who you are. Somebody's going to like you for who you are. And they're going to be so appreciative of it, man. So anyways, that's really it. And that's really it for this episode. Hopefully that was impactful to you. Like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned in for the next episode.